Okay, next we are going to discuss about the different type of motion. So far we discussed about the dynamics, robo dynamics, how to develop a mathematical model for a robo, how we are going to apply kinetic energy and the potential energy expression in the Lagrange's expression. So finally we obtain the mathematical model. Okay, so next is motion. Okay, what are the different type of motion in a system? Okay, suppose a robo manipulator is here. So when the, say this is one joint, this is another joint, so this is a end effector, end of arm. So now assume this joint is at 30 degree, this joint has 45 degree. So when these two joint makes, initially when my hand is at 30 degree, theta 1 30 degree, theta 2 45 degree. So we are all engineers, we are all control engineers. We have to make, we have to plan, we have to give command to the motor, to the motor, to make certain particular values of velocity and acceleration. Okay, so that suppose this joint has x and y, so this is whole space coordinate, these two are joint space coordinate. Suppose if we want to move this x and y, x1 y1 to another, say now this is a new position, so from this juncture to this position to move the robo, what are the amount of a new velocity or acceleration to be developed at these two joints so as to reach this? So to reach from one position to another position, the control program has different types. The type of motions are called slew motion, joint interpolated motion, and the straight line motion. Straight line motion, we require the inverse kinematic solution to perform the straight line motion. Okay, so today we see what are all called what are the different type of motion. With an example we will see what is joint interpolated slew motion, what is joint interpolated motion, and straight line motion. Okay, so the types of motion. Okay, types of motion. The types of motion, actually motion motion of a manipulated joint, okay, is very important to control, to write the program, control program of a robo. So motion planning, there are three types of motion. This is slew motion. Next is joint interpolated motion. Third one is straight line motion. So what is slow motion? Slow, say for example, I'll explain. Say here one motor. This is the end effector. So here one motor. So there are theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. Okay. So this is the point P1. We are all engineers. We are going to develop a robo control program. We have to write the program. Controlling program to move one point to another position accurately. Okay, so if the robo end effector, this P1, move from this point to this point, say P2, move from this end to this end, we are all engineers, instrumentation engineers, motor 1, M1, M2, M3. So three motors are attached at the joints along with the feedback. So it has to reach P2. There are two ways. We have to reach the position P2 within short duration, within specified time. That is one possibility. Another, that means at all joints simultaneously rotate with the same velocity. Suppose all the three motor rotate at the same velocity. When the all motor is having same speed, say this initially, this motor, this theta 1 is say 20 degree, theta 2 is say 35 degree, theta 3 is say 46 degree. Okay, so to reach this position, assume, this theta 1 has to move like this, then theta 2 move like this, theta 3 again this. So this motor has to move from 20 degrees to some theta x1, say theta 1, theta f1. So the this joint has to move for another angle of theta F2. Finally, this theta F3. So from one position to another position, it has to make movement. So there are one thing is, if all the three motors rotate at the same speed, which motor will reach, which joint will reach its final position? Very less displacement. The motor, the joint has less displacement to reach the final value. Then what it will do? If the motor is continuously rotating around that point until all other joints reach its final position. So that type of motion called slow motion. Slow motion means each joint takes its own time. Not at all same. So each joint has its own timing to reach. That means three joints are the all joints rotates with the different accelerations and the decelerations. Okay, so it accelerate or decelerate to reduce the speed. Okay, so the profile of the scheme is like a railway track. Say in the railway engine control system is like a trapezium. Okay, initially the profile of railway tracking control system, so when the from the station one, say this is station 1, this is station 2, from the station 1 the engine of the railway bogie gets accelerated Okay, initially it gets accelerated. So once it after some time, so after this period, it reaches, it maintains the constant speed. It maintains the constant speed. When the next station comes, okay, so before the next station comes, the engine acceleration should be decelerated. Then only it will stop in the railway station exactly. So that is called deceleration period. Deceleration. Okay, acceleration, deceleration. So this is the profile of a railway track. So the same profile is applicable in the robo control system, motion planning control system. So this period is T acceleration. This period is T acceleration. This period is T time deceleration. This is the time max, that is normal time. So T max, so maximum time duration. Okay, so this type of motion called slew motion. So what is slew motion? Is the simplest form of motion, as robo move from one point to another point, point A to point B. The manipulator travels as quickly as possible from its initial position to the final position. All axes begins moving. All axes begins moving at the same time. So at t equal to zero, all the joints start moving. Okay, but each axis ends at different time period. Okay, so simultaneously starts, but ends at different time period. So this is called slew motion. Okay, let's see one example with simple example. Whereas first we finish the slew motion causes wear and tear effect for the motor and the gear system, the robo system. That is disadvantage. Joint interpolated motion is nothing but it all joints start simultaneously ends at same time. Okay, all axes take same time to end up the end the final point. So that is called joint interpolation motion. It is similar to slew motion only, but it takes optimum time for all joints, say ends at same time period, not at different. So if all simultaneously starts, begins, ends at different time period, settled time period is slew motion. So this is joint interpolation motion. Okay, this method depends on the speed to accomplish the motion. Okay, next is a straight line motion. In this motion, robo travels in a straight line between the two points, start and stop points. But this can be very difficult. It requires complex program. Okay, complex program. It requires some specified path profile, quadratic profile. Those we will do some programming manipulations in future lectures, right? So first we see a simple example. How the slew motion occur here. You see, a three axis manipulator, so R, three axis, 3 degree of freedom manipulator. So three axis manipulator, 3 degree of freedom manipulator, all are revolute joints, that is rotational joints, start with an angle. You see, theta 1 is 40 degree, theta 2 is 80 degree, theta 3 is minus 40 degree. So initial position. So initial positions are 80 minus 40 degrees. And must move to the new position. It has to move. Theta 1 should be 120, theta 2 should be 0, and theta 3 also should be 0. You see, it has to move theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 from this position to final position of theta f1, theta f2, theta f3. Theta f3. So assume that all joints have maximum absolute acceleration and deceleration. So the maximum acceleration or deceleration is 50, 100, 150. Say the joint motor, the motor acceleration M1, acceleration of M1 is 50, M2, M3. So degrees per second square, and the maximum velocity is also given for each motor. M1, MV1, this is MA1, MA2, MA3, MV1, MV2, MV3. Using slow motion, what is the travel time for each joint? What is the travel time for each joint? Please do. First, we have to estimate the distance displacement performed by the joint, as well as the time duration, time during acceleration and deceleration. Time during acceleration and deceleration. Please do it. I'll explain this. This is the path profile. You see, this is joint angle versus time period. This joint angle versus time period. This is the joint velocity. This is the profile of the slow motion robo. So the theta one, say this is theta one. Initially the theta one is at what angle? Theta one is 40 degrees to 120 degree. So it has to move from 40 degrees to theta one, move from 40 degrees to 120 degree. You see here. What is the difference from 40 degrees to 120 degree? See, this is theta 3, theta 3 from this end to this end, theta 2. First, calculate the acceleration time and deceleration time. What is acceleration and deceleration time? T acceleration equal to T deceleration, because you see in the profile the acceleration and the deceleration both are equal only. Okay, both are equal. So T acceleration deceleration equal to what are the parameters given here? You see velocity given, acceleration given. So velocity divided by acceleration will give you the time for acceleration. Okay, so omega max, omega max divided by acceleration max. Okay, so omega max divided by acceleration max. What is the omega max for first joint? 50. 50 divided, not 50. Oh, omega max is 20 divided by 50. Then 40 divided by 100. The second joint, 40 divided by 100. The third joint, how much? 150? 50 divided by 150. 50 divided by please calculate and tell me what is the t acceleration, that is both are same, t deceleration equal to 20 by 50 0.4. This is also 0.4 second. This is 0.33.
Yes, sir. 0.33
second. So this is we calculated the t acceleration deceleration. Let's find the position, final position, that is the theta during acceleration and deceleration. The angular position, the angular position during acceleration and deceleration. Okay. So what is theta acceleration equal to time acceleration into omega maximum velocity divided by 2. So what do you please, the t acceleration is 0.4 into 20 into 20 divided by 2. Similarly, for next joint, 0.4 into 40 divided by 2. Then 0.33 into 50 divided by 2. The third displacement is 0.33 into 50 divided by 2. So the theta acceleration equal to equal to 4 degrees 28.33 degrees. Okay, so next is to examine how much displacement done by each joint. Okay, the third one is what is the displacement done by each joint. Okay, theta move, that is theta move equal to theta final minus initial, okay, or theta end minus theta start. So theta moves equal to first joint from 120 to final is 120, initial is 40. 120 minus 40. Then second one is 0 minus 80. Third one is zero minus of minus. What is the first one? 120 minus 40, comma. What is for second? Zero minus 80. Third one is zero minus of minus 40 degrees. So how much 80 degree minus 80 degree 40 degree. This is the final position, final degrees. A theta moves. Okay. Now the remove. Now we have to remove the angle. Remove the angles covered during acceleration and deceleration. Angles covered during acceleration or deceleration. Okay, so with the travel time at maximum, and find the travel time at the maximum maximum time period. Okay, so the time maximum time period t maximum, that is during this period. So we have to first, now we are going to estimate this. We are neglecting the angle during this period and the angle during this period. So we are going to estimate only at the maximum time period. So for that, the difference, we are removing the angle during, remove the angle covered during the acceleration and deceleration. So T max equal to move, theta move minus two times, actually displacement time equal to velocity. So now we are going to use this formula. Actually, what is the formula? Omega max equal to displacement by T max. So what is T max? T max equal to displacement by omega max. The displacement, we have to remove the displacement covered during the axis. That's why theta move minus, if you two times theta acceleration by omega max. Please calculate for first two one is theta move. What is theta move for first 80 degree? So 80 degree minus two times. What is theta deceleration we calculated here for first? The angle during acceleration is 4. 2 into 4. 2 into 4 divided by omega max is 20, comma. Next move, just to take magnitude alone, next is 80. Next 80, big 80 minus 2 times 8 divided by 2 divided by 40. Omega max for second joint is 40. The third is 40 minus 2 times third angle theta. 8.33, 2 into 8.33 divided by omega max. Omega max is 50. So here 50. So please calculate. This is the time during the steady period. Okay, steady period. What is that? 3.6 comma 1.6 comma 0.467 seconds. So this is T max. Now tell me the what is the total time? The total time taken by the joints, by the joints, T total equal to T acceleration plus T max plus T deceleration. So what is the value? So add 0.4 T acceleration for the first joint is 0.4. T maximum for first joint is 3.6. T deceleration is again 0.4. So 1.13 seconds. What it tells, the first motor takes. So this indicates motor 1, M1 takes 4.4 seconds to reach from which angle to which angle? From 40 degrees to 120 degrees. From 40 degree initial position to final 120 degree. So it takes 4.4 seconds. M2 takes just 2.4 seconds. M3, motor 3 takes 1.13 seconds. So each joint settle at different period, but they start simultaneously, start at same time, but end at different schedules. Do you understand what I am saying? This is called slow motion. Any doubt? Hello. Okay. Suppose if we design the same problem with joint interpolated motion, means what is the maximum time required by the individual motor? So what is the maximum time required by the individual motor? 4.4 seconds, right? 4.4 seconds. So in the joint interpolated motion, what our program will do, all start simultaneously, but all end, the end, okay? So whatever will make the case, end at the maximum of 4.4 seconds. Whereas here each motor takes different time period with different acceleration and deceleration. But in this case, in joint interpolated motion, all the three motors reach the optimum time period of 4.4 seconds. Okay, so this is the difference between slow motion and joint interpolated motion. So the programming techniques require the joint angle, joint velocity, joint acceleration, and dynamic model of the robot system.